straight. So we have every business is about a business structure. So either you are a sole proprietor, venture capitalist, or you call it venture capital partnership, or you are a one-man business, a sole proprietor, because whichever business structure you are dealing with, and business is about profit making as well. So whatever you're doing, whatever investment, whatever you are selling, whatever service you are providing, it's for an end product of profit. So very important. If you are doing an NGO, it's a bit different. Social entrepreneurship, some people make money from there, but the usual business that we call business in the sense of the word is profit making. You are either dealing in a product or a service. You are selling something tangible or something intangible for profit or for money, for cash. And business is location based too as well, so you have to be physically located as a business, either in a community or in satellite locations. And then the market, you must have a market of customers that you are dealing with, driven by the forces of demand and supply. Very important. So as a business, you must know all that. You must know your market that you are dealing with and what people want to buy and what you can supply at what price to make money. And then you must also know how the business evolves over time, so you can also evolve your business to serve a need, because you have a business when you provide services that people are willing to pay for. Business is customer driven. You must start business from a need point of view. Very important. So as a business, you know, we all know that you are serving a particular need that people are ready to pay for, and that's how you make profit. So it's very important to also know how that need evolves over time, either by product modification or even changing the whole thing altogether. So you are selling a different product altogether. So very important. So business without technology, the usual one that we know, is very physical. You must move something from here to the other, drive to a different location and all that. Very physical, that we know, and it's very local, so it's community based. You are dealing with the people in the physical environment, it's labor driven. You must have human, factor in that business. You have more employees, you have thousands of people who are working for you, which technology can easily change, and it's very expensive in maintaining that with your aim of making business, and usually it's quite unpredictable. You don't know what can happen tomorrow, something can change, and then you lose your business or you don't make profit. Analytics, we don't have the complex analytics that we have with the aid of technology. It's just a linear technology, it's a linear analytics. If they eat watching, it's always watching. You don't know whether somebody, they've acquired a taste of eating some sardine in addition to the watching. So you're always thinking about watching every little. There's no more cow in the system. And you don't know that the person who has just come from the university who has acquired taste for geisha or another titus or sardine will want the sardine and watch it. So you always think one way. So instead of just they coming to eat at the physical location, how do I deliver it to them? So they are working now, so they are not mobile at first. So and research informed. And right now, it's quite difficult even working with some particular research document because it's very traditional. By the time you are done with focus group discussion and you finish all those graphing and charting, the consumer has already changed his mind. So if you think this consumer likes product A, B, C, D, and this functionality, by the time maybe you are done with the research document, they've changed their mind on two or three things to affect your results. So we see how technology is going to change that situation and how we can integrate it into the business of things. So this is just some facts about the internet. Because business is physical, technology is virtual. Even though it's also physical, some components of technologies are physical as virtual. You have the fiber cables coming from different countries through the sea, your physical location in Ghana, and you can integrate it to the social or the local system. So on a day on the internet, this information you consume 168 million DVDs of information, 294 billion videos sent every day. You have 2 million blog written posts, which you can use to public time magazine for 770 years. We have 172 million visits to Facebook, 40 million visits to Twitter, 22 to LinkedIn, 4.7 billion minutes spent on Facebook every day. We have the status updated, 532 million, 53 million photos are uploaded, 864,000 hours of videos are uploaded to YouTube every day. So as a business who wants to integrate technology into your scheme of things, these are figures that you work with. How much of the content being consumed is your business content? How much of the emails being sent is to make inquiry about your business or you sending a reply to an inquiry? And then the blogs being written, is somebody writing positive things about your business that others can get attracted to, that they can come as the first time customers that you can keep? And then people are updating their Facebook status, they are uploading photographs. Did they come to your joint to eat with their food and they took photographs, tag their friends for their friends of their friends to see? So that you get that benefit of the viral feature of social media. And then we have hours of videos being uploaded. Does it include your documentary, your commercial, your infomercial, or anything about your business? Very important. So if you have internet apps like this, you see how you can also fit in as a business. That came up with what I call the 10 C's of tech-driven business. It's about the customer, your commodity, commerce, campaigns, communication, culture, contacts, community, competence, cost. So these are the 10 things I came together, I developed, that technology can affect or have influence on in your business. So the first one